When we think about addictions, the first thing that comes to mind may be related to drugs or alcohol, but there are other kinds of addictions that can be harder to recognize. Have you ever heard about being addicted to your smartphone? James has noticed that his friend Anthony is always on his phone and is showing signs of addiction. James wants to learn more about this issue to help his friend improve his mental health. In today's society, with technology at our fingertips, the use and benefits of smartphones speak for themselves. The ability to access any information within seconds is quite fascinating, but have people ever wondered about any of the negative effects that come along with abusing the smartphone? The use of smartphones has exploded over the years. It is predicted that in 2023, 7.33 out of approximately 8.1 billion people will own a smartphone. As the use of smartphones continues to rise, it is essential to raise awareness about the potential for addiction and the associated signs and symptoms. So, what is smartphone addiction? It is not officially classified as a mental health disorder, but it does share many of the features associated with addictions. While there is no standard definition, it can be described as problematic phone use, even when it is known to be harmful. Some of the signs and symptoms include withdrawal, difficulty exercising control, and a negative impact on everyday life. These signs can often be hard to identify, so let's take a look at an example. Anthony has an assignment due at 11:59 p.m., which he has not yet started. He gets back home at 2 p.m., lays in bed, trapped by TikToks and YouTube videos. Now, it's 6 p.m. Although he knows the assignment is important, he just can't get himself to put down his phone. When it reaches 10 p.m., he finally starts his assignment because his phone died. What do we observe from this situation? First, there is difficulty with control, as he cannot put the phone down on his own. This negatively impacts his daily life, as his schoolwork will suffer. There is also dependence, because Anthony feels like he needs to be on his phone. These are all things that can indicate smartphone addiction and must be acknowledged, because as with any type of addiction, there can be serious health consequences. It has been found that smartphone addiction can lead to anxiety and stress, social withdrawal, loneliness, insomnia, sleep disturbances, and much more. The most significant toll it takes is on mental health, as smartphone addiction leads to certain behavior patterns. One of these is reassurance seeking, which is when one feels the need to constantly check their phone or notifications. Another is the fear of missing out, or FOMO pattern, where one needs to be on their phone constantly in case something happens. Both these patterns contribute to depression and anxiety, making smartphone addiction a serious issue to consider. Hearing about these patterns and symptoms can be a bit scary. You may even relate to some of these things, but there are important distinctions to remember. Addiction is not simply based on the time spent on one's phone, but rather the behavior while on the phone. Two individuals could spend the same amount of time on the phone, but an addicted individual would be compulsive and scattered in their use, while a non-addict would have a constant and direct focus. James had stumbled upon this article by Al Hessen and colleagues, which he wanted to show Anthony. This study observed the association between smartphone addiction and depression among adults in the Middle East. This study was conducted through the use of an online questionnaire, which had received 935 complete responses. Of these participants, 619 were female and 316 were male. Researchers ultimately concluded a strong association between smartphone addiction and depression. Further findings also concluded that higher addiction scores were associated with younger age groups, showing that younger generations are more susceptible to smartphone addictions and therefore more susceptible to decreases in mental health. After learning all this, James decided to bring up his concerns with Anthony, in hopes of making Anthony more aware of his possible addiction. Anthony shared he has felt his mood go down, especially when his Instagram posts don't gain the attention he expected. James empathizes with Anthony and suggests that he take a break from social media in hopes of reducing Anthony's dependence on his phone. At first, Anthony struggled with this, but James decided he would also delete social media to support Anthony. They found that turning off their phone completely helped with their tendency to grab their phone and check their notifications. To combat smartphone addiction, it is first and foremost important to raise awareness so that people can learn about what it means and recognize it. This will ultimately make it possible to take the necessary steps to reduce and prevent smartphone addiction. Some practical things you can do are limit screen time, turn off notifications, and avoid using your phone before bed, as this can lead your body to think that you need your phone to sleep. It is also good to explore alternative ways to relax that can help replace phone use. A few options include reading a book, going on a walk, seeing friends, meditating, baking, going to the gym, or crafts. These are great activities that can help take the place of the time spent on your smartphone. I hope that this video has helped you recognize addiction behaviors and maybe inspired you to take the next step in supporting yourself, friends, or family. If you'd like to watch more content like this, please subscribe for more videos. Thank you!